Praise be Jesus Christ. My dear lovers of the Word of God, welcome to Anbinhi. On this 27th Sunday in Ordinary Time, we do celebrate the Indigenous Sunday, the day we pray and acknowledge our brothers and sisters who are inheritors and practitioners of our unique cultures. Let us now give reverence to the words of our Master. This is about the parable of the tenants from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "Hear another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a hedge around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a tower. Then he leased it to tenants and went on a journey. When vintage time drew near, he sent his servants to the tenants to obtain his produce. But the tenants seized the servants, and one they beat, another they killed, and a third they stoned. Again he sent other servants more numerous than the first ones, but they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, thinking, 'They will respect my son.' But when the tenants saw the son, they said to one another, 'This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and acquire his inheritance.' They seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. What will the owner of the vineyard do to those tenants when he comes?" They answered him, "He will put those wretched men to a wretched death, and lease his vineyard to other tenants, who will give him the produce at the proper times." Jesus said to them, "Did you never read in the scriptures, 'The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done, and it is wonderful in our eyes.' Therefore I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that will produce its fruit." The Gospel of the Lord. Indigenous people are our ancestors. They have retained our social, cultural, economic, and political characteristics. When we look at them, we look at our own original features. When we observe them, we can take pride of our original behavior. Generous, industrious, strong-willed, close family ties, possess a sense of community, bayanihan, hospitable, cheerful. I remember when we visited a tribal group in the upland part of the province of Aurora. They are called Dumagats. One morning when we were taking our breakfast with them, I gave one hot pandesal to a small boy. His name is Liro. He was grateful upon receiving the newly baked bread. What he did was, he went to his mother and handed the pandesal to his mother. Then the mother made three pieces from the bread. One for Liro, one for the younger brother of Liro, and the smallest portion was left with hers. Upon seeing this beautiful sharing of bread, I said to myself, this is the true trait of Filipinos. This is one of the original characteristics. of us. But reviewing the researches about the natives of our country, who represent 14% of our country's population, they are among the poorest and the most disadvantaged social group in our country. There is illiteracy, unemployment, and incidence of poverty are much higher among them than the rest of the population. That is why reflecting on the gospel about the murder committed by the tenants, we do have one way or another have killed our original traits. We do not even want them to see because their faces do not please our eyes. But isn't it that we originated in the same features as they have? Our traditional culture is being overpowered by modern culture. And this modern culture become the culture of death that St. John Paul II said, who take pride on physical beauty, popularity, extreme greed for wealth, or material gain. With this culture of death, our values for integrity is being compromised with reason that we want to protect our image. Where do honesty hides? Uprightness, trustworthiness, fairness, loyalty, and the courage to keep one's word and one's promises, regardless of the consequences. Is not it that the word integrity derives from the Latin for wholeness, and it denotes a man who has successfully integrated all good virtues, who not only talks the talk, but walks the walk. Every day, we are faced with little decisions that reflect on our integrity. Is it wrong to do a little casual act when your wife isn't around? If you missed a lot of class, can you tell your professor a family member died? Is it okay to kill in order to solve drug dependent and users, drug pushers, and drug lords in our society? Just like in the parable, their actions are no longer dictated by their conscience. They just kill the servants of the landowner because they want to grab the harvest and the vineyard itself. Their dreadful act worsened when they killed the heir of the vineyard. This murderous act of the tenants rings a bell, isn't it? The tenants kill without giving justice to people sent by the landowner. What matters to them was their own personal motivation and concerns. So they kill. They were not aware that they have killed their own conscience. They killed their own integrity. They killed the trust of the landowner. And they have killed their own soul. It's the same thing to those who commit extrajudicial killings, those who kill the future of the families of those murdered. If there is no justification for unethical behavior, much more that there is no justification for committing murder. As what the fifth commandment says, you shall not kill. With the fifth commandment, our Lord asked for peace of heart and denounced murderous anger and hatred as immoral. In the Catechism of the Catholic Church, Article 2305 says, by the blood of his cross, in his own person, he killed the hostility. He reconciled man with God and made his church the sacrament of the unity of the human race and its union with God. So let us ask the Holy Spirit to sanctify our way of thinking, so that all that we do is directed to life and everybody's salvation. After all, we are already saved by the Son of the Father, our Lord Jesus Christ. We only have to observe His commandments and live with the grace of life that our Master continue to bestow on us. With this, we give honor to our origin, our indigenous brothers and sisters. In this way too, we can help our culture and true values to remain in all the Filipinos' hearts. Thank you, my dear brothers and sisters in faith. Thank you for your trust as we continue to bring to you God's message of our salvation. And may the Word of God grow in our mind, in our will, and in our heart. God bless you.
تحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله أمواتا بل أحياء عند ربهم
Thank you. in response to the love of God, who has called me to follow more closely Christ the Master, way and truth and life, among the daughters of St. Paul. Profession, and in response to the love of God, who has called me to follow more closely Christ the Master, way and truth and life, among the daughters of St. Paul, I, in full freedom, renew the offering of myself to the Father, having been consecrated by Him in Christ. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, I recommit myself to live in communion with my sisters and to be faithful to the charism of the Founder, dedicating myself in the Church to evangelization with the means of social communication.